Hey everybody, TGonlinemixing from Visionary Music Group here. Hope you're doing great. We have another short mix tip video today to help you with your mixing. This one is about using auxes and aux returns for parallel compression and EQ effects and processing. Hope you enjoy the video. Here we go. So do you ever notice in a lot of pro mixes or mixes that you really like how there's this kind of dance, like a pulsing movement of the tracks going on, and it's exciting and it changes throughout the song? It's not the same when you do it yourself. You get your nice balance, it sounds great, you think it's all cool frequency wise, you put your reverb on, it gives it a little bit of space, but you still don't have that pump and that breathing and that excitement and that expanse. The way to do it is with parallel effects, meaning compression and or EQ, to help you and shape tonally your mix. So here's what we do in our session. So we're looking at our buses here, and we have all our effects ends, we have different things mapped out. But you get down here, it says sidechain A, B, C, D, tape sidechain. There's numerous ones, they're set up, they're ready to go. So let's dig in and see what they are. Our sidechain A is an analog insert using our API 2500 compressor. Sidechain A is driven by all the drums, percussion loops, percussive effects, and the basses. So it glues that part of the rhythm section together. Sidechain B, I have it labeled sides. That's for anything that goes out to the sides. Keyboards, keyboard pads, ambient guitars that are bouncing around. And I use this Neve compressor as well as this Brainworks EQ more to spread it out. And I can automate this out if I want in the choruses, make it sound bigger. Sidechain C is a little different. It's sort of the extra, you know, the extra gear, the overdrive gear, you know, the extra gas boost in the car. I use the 1176 for sidechain C, because it adds a mid-range bite and aggressive nature to the track that it didn't have for anything you send to it. Usually I'll just put a bunch of things in it and see what works. Then I have this Distressor track. This is the software version of the Empirical Labs Distressors, which are killer compressors. I use this for all my drum shells, meaning kick or any kicks I have in it, snares, toms, and that's it, possibly rooms. Then I like to do something different for the kick and the snare, and I always like the old DBX 160, so the UAD version's great. I use that as a kick and snare drum crush, which adds a little finished attack to those two instruments. And what you'll notice too, in a mix like this is a hard rock tune, there's a lot of guitars roaring around. You're gonna need to do these things to the drums to get them to sort of lift to another level, and that's what this helps. Then the low end, gluing that together. The kick and the bass always felt separate to me in mixes, and I started to think, well, why don't I try to send them to one thing to glue them together? So I did. I had a retro Gates copy, the retro stay level, and that was awesome, and I used that for years. And then I just, you know, got tired of replacing tubes and dealing with analog stuff in the heat. And when I got the Shadow Hills compressor, I A-B'd it, and I thought it was really good. It was close, and it did nice things to the low end. So that's my, you know, my bass and kick glue compressor choice. So my second and additional choice is the Billy Decker Bus Glue Bass Compressor plugin, which is more than a compressor. It shapes and does everything. His whole series is great, and you'll see I use them throughout the mix. Then I have just a sidechain just for bass to give it a little help to compete. And once again, it's Billy Decker on that, which is killer. And then I have a bass sub. So in this case, I have this Alesia EQ set up to crank a bunch of low end, and I usually have this BX subsynth on there, but it's muted for this tune. It didn't really need it. So it's available. So once again, once you map these out and you do your experimenting and you try, you keep them in there and you keep them available and you use them when you need them. So then for guitars, I have sidechains. I usually have an LA-3A, but in this case, on this mix, I found something else. One of my alternates was the SSL G compressor, and sometimes I use the Townhouse compressor. The Townhouse has a little more high-end fizz to it, and the SSLG has a little more growl. So it depends on what's necessary, how they were recorded, what's going on for the song. Billy Decker, again, is a great sidechain for electrics, and then lead vocals and background vocals. So my main lead vocal sidechain is, once again, that 1176. Now, you might ask me, well, why don't you just send it to the other one, sidechain C? What happens a lot of times when if I'm pushing the vocal sidechains, they start to sound too up front, so I have to apply some of the vocal effect sends to them. So I just drag them and copy them over. But I can't do that if it's in the whole mix, sidechain C. So this allows me that option. Then if I want a vocalist to have a little more low end, I go to the Shadow Hills. Then I have a third option, which is something I may add if I want to have some brightness and attack. It's the Slate Distressor, but their API EQ and this other EQ they have, to sort of give it a little attack, a little bite, and some high end. And I can adjust that accordingly. Then on our background vocals, we have Billy Decker Vox plugin, which is great. And then I have the UAD Fairchild pretty much set, maxed out to stun. So there's a rundown of all our sidechain processing that I have in the mix. So I'm going to mute them now. We're going to play the mix and see what it does when I turn them on. Now the levels are going to change because I worked into them, so, but you'll hear the dramatic effect. The dream's not us to keep. Awake and this is out. Madness is now complete. Long, long, long gone. Now in. The dream's not us to keep. Awake and disbelieve. Madness is now complete. Cool, definitely helps. So here's something to keep in mind too. These are set pretty low, so they can be turned up as needed. So if in a chorus, you want to push something, you can ride that up. Say you want the drum rooms or the drum shell compressor to hit harder, or you want to kick in that sidechain C to make the chorus get some aggression that it didn't have, you can ride it up or automate it in and out. So you can use these to create excitement, to create a depth, to create a pumping, to create all kinds of colors that you wouldn't normally have with just your EQ and directly putting compressors on the channels. So that's our parallel compression and EQ processing. We hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give us a like, give us a thumbs up. Please subscribe. We do appreciate your support. Hit the notification bell. We'll let you know when we have more content like this. And anytime, drop me a comment or a question. I'd love to see what you do with your parallel processing. Thanks again. Happy mixing.